Well, hello and welcome to week three of Holy Trinity Holiday Club. It's great to see you. Thanks for sending in all your news and your pictures. We are loving them. We're going to come to some of those in a few minutes' time. But we've been on a bit of a journey so far, haven't we? We've been learning the Bible in four words. Can you remember them? Wow! God loves us and He made an amazing world. Uh-oh! We don't listen to God. It's stupid. We don't listen to God. And we want to do life our way. And that leaves us stuck. Now, we're going to come to our next word in just a minute. But we're going to sing a song first. It's a song we sung last week. It's a call and response song. And actually, there's a clue in this song as to our next word. See if you can spot it.
God is a holy God.
God is a holy God.
We can't be friends because of our sin.
We can't be friends because of our sin.
God is a holy God.
God is a holy God.
We can't be friends because of our sin.
We can't be
sin. Jesus died to wash us clean. When we put our trust in Him, God opens His arms and welcomes us in.
God opens His arms and welcomes us in.
God is a holy God.
God is a holy God.
We can't be friends because of our sin.
We can't be
household, we often find ourselves playing prisons, and it nearly always ends up like this, with me stuck. But actually, that's what the Bible says life is like for each of us. We're all in prison because of our sin. We are stupid. We don't want to listen to God. We try to do things our way, and it doesn't work. It means we can't be friends with God. It means we can't live with Him forever. But this is where our third word comes in. I wonder if you can guess what it is. Wow. Uh-oh. Yes. Think of our memory verse. But God demonstrates His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Jesus died for us. You see, we sin and it leaves us stuck in prison. But God still loves us and He had a plan.
This is the plan we read about in the Bible, that God would send a baby born of a virgin. His name would be Jesus, which means God saves. Even as a boy, people knew He was special. But then He grew up, and a man named John announced that the King who would save us from sin was coming, the Son of God. And Jesus started to do amazing things. He healed those who were sick. He gave sight to the blind, people that couldn't see. He miraculously fed people with some bread and some fish. And then He would do the hardest thing that anyone has ever done. Even He was scared. You see, He was arrested, insulted, chained, hit. All His friends abandoned Him. And then He was nailed to a cross to die, as if He was a sinner. But actually, He was dying for our sins. He was taking them away so that there would be no more, uh-oh, we could be friends with God now. Yes! the sins would be gone, even us who read the story today. Yes.
It's like he paid the price for us.
Because of our sin, we can't go free. We deserve to die.
But Jesus was perfect. He didn't deserve to die.
And so he wasn't in prison like us.
But Jesus chose to die for us. He was killed on a wooden cross as if he was a criminal, even though he'd done nothing wrong. But as he died, he paid the price for us.
And so we can be free! Hooray!
But do you know what? It doesn't stop there. Jesus didn't stay dead. 3 days later, he beat death. He was alive again. People saw him. He was the first person to beat death forever. And because he's alive, we know that we can live forever too and be friends with God and never die. The way is open. Now, doesn't that make you want to say yes? Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. You see, sometimes we don't think it's much of a problem that we sin, that we, don't listen to God. But when we realise how bad it is and how stuck we are, then Jesus dying for us makes us go, yes! It makes us want to celebrate that Jesus would die for people like us. And we're going to now get on our feet, because it's time for the memory verse. And we're going to have a celebration memory verse. You ready?
Hi everybody, it's Greg here with today's memory verse with my little helper. What's your name?
I know,
it's Scarlett. So today, following on, what we're going to do with loads of energy, loads of celebration, dances and jumps about in today's memory verse. So what we're going to do, I want you to all shout yes and jump in the air, throw your hands about after each line, correct. And what we're going to do, we're going to have a bouncy, bouncy high knee for the first line, and then we're going to say yes, as if we've scored a goal in football, or we've done a real good gymnastics move, or we've landed that skateboard trick, and then we'll move on to the next line. And after the next line, we've got a little burpee. Well, we were all sinners, we jump up and yes again afterwards. And then we get on to the next line, which is Jesus died for us. Yes! And then Romans 5, verse 8. Okay, are we ready then? Let's have a little go. Right? So it's a bouncy high knee, so we're skipping on the spot, getting those knees up nice and high, okay? And let's see if I can get the first line right, because I've been missing out a word. Okay, you're going to help me. Okay, are we ready? I'm saying okay a lot again. I've got to stop that as well. I've got to remember to add that word in and stop and take that word out. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. Yes! While we were still sinners,
yes,
Jesus died for us, yes. Romans 5, verse 8. Woo! One more time, shall we?
Yeah.
That was good, wasn't it? That was good. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. Woo! Yes! While we were still sinners,
yes!
Jesus died for us.
Yes! Romans
5. Verse 8. Yes!
Thanks, Greg and Scarlett. Now, I think it's time for some news.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Jonah List, the reporter.
And I'm Ray Porter, the journalist.
And welcome to HT News. The headline today:
Jesus has died for our sins.
But isn't that, like, old news?
It may have happened 2,000 years ago, but it is still the best and the most important news ever.
True, true, yeah. It does make you want to say, good.
Yes.
Yes, yes, that's the word, yes.
Yeah. Our second headline.
Where are all the forks?
First we had forks. Then we had sporks, like Forky. And now all we have are spoons.
I've always been suspicious of that Forky.
It's a takeover.
And next.
Unbelievable sheep sighting.
Sheep have been getting lost all over our world. Here.
And here, I don't even know where that is.
And here.
Sophie's has got particularly lost. Sophie, keep a better eye on your sheep.
Well done, Sophie. There's a prize coming to you very soon. Do you know what? I haven't found my sheep. It got lost a while ago and I just can't find it anywhere.
Hope you find it soon.
There we go. Anyway, it's time for the weather. Over to Wayne.
Why don't I go and have a look? It is raining.
Thanks, Wayne. Guess it was better than last time.
And it really is raining in Senegal. Take a look.
Wow, it is really raining there. But Thomas and Esther didn't let it get them down.
No, in fact, it got them up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down.
In other news today.
A penguin grows a beard.
I didn't even know they could grow beards. Simon eats an Oreo, but that's not news.
Take a look at this Oreo.
Oh!
Deep fresh Oreo. A Debbie to remember.
Elijah played his first match for his football team and they won 10-0.
10-0? Wow.
Elijah played in goal and didn't let in one single goal. Well done, Elijah.
And now it's time for the Find Something Random challenge. Jonah and everyone else, I would like you to find a teddy bear. Go. Jonah.
Hope you did better than me. Anyway, that's it for today.
See you soon.
Goodbye.
So I wonder how many times we've said our word for today already. Should we say it again? Yes? No, that wasn't me saying the word yes. That was me saying, should we say the word? Oh, don't worry. It's time to sing. And we're going to sing a yes song about our rescuer.
There is so much bad news in the world right now, but no matter what, we have good news, and that good news has a name, and that name is Jesus Christ.
There is good news for the captive, good news for the shame. There is good news for the world who walked away. There is good news for the doubter, come to seek and save. He's our rescuer. He's our rescuer. We are free from sin forevermore. Oh, how sweet this song.
great song to sing together about our rescuer. Now, we have loved Sonia and Imogen's craft work over the last few weeks. I hope you've enjoyed doing it too. But I wonder what our yes craft will be today. Let's go over to them now.
Hello, I'm Sonia and this is Imogen, and we're going to help you make a forgiveness cross today. All you're going to need is a piece of paper, some pens or pencils for colouring in, and a pair of scissors. So Imogen, do you think that I can make this piece of paper into a cross with just three folds and a pair of scissors?
Yes.
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 Take your one piece of paper, fold one corner over to the long edge, like that. Take the other pointed corner and fold it over to the other edge so it looks like a house. Now let's fold our house in half. Bit like you're making a paper aeroplane. It's actually three folds. Right now with your scissors, I want you to do one cut all the way down there.
Okay,
so it's nearer this side. So probably about a third or a quarter. Now this bit, just get rid of, we don't need that bit, so we can recycle that bit. Do you think we've made a cross?
Yes.
Let's see.
Yes,
we did it. Right, but it doesn't look very much like a forgiveness cross, and it's not going to help us remember our word for this week, is it? So, choose a pen. So, Jesus died on the cross to forgive us our sins.
Yes.
So, we're going to write the word forgive, and I want to make sure we've got the R in the middle. So, we'll do the R first. Forgive, F. O-R-G-I-V-E. Now, what is he forgiving us? Why did he die on the cross for? Your sins. So, put your sins. But there's a hidden message in this. What is our word for this week that we're learning?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, it is. Can you see yes hidden in your cross? Shall I show you?
Yes.
Y-E-S. Look. Yes, we can make a forgiveness cross. Now you can decorate it however you like. There's just an example there for you. And we've got the Y-E-S in yellow so you can see it. There's another one. Can't wait to see all your forgiveness crosses. Yes.
Thanks, Sonia and Imogen. What a great craft to do together. I'm looking forward to seeing those pictures too. But there's one really important thing we haven't done yet, which is to pray. Because when we understand what Jesus has done for us, it makes us want to talk to God, be in a relationship with him, which is all praying is, just talking to God, our friend. Our best friend. And Anani and Noah and Sophie are going to lead us in prayer now.
Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for creating such a wonderful world. We look around at the animals and say, wow. Thank you. Amen.
Dear God, sorry for when we go our own way and don't follow you. Uh-oh. Amen.
Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus to die for us. Yes. Amen.
Amen!
So, on this journey we're going on, there's only one more word to go. That'll be next week. Join us again. In the meantime, send us your news, your pictures, and your videos. We love reading them. And your challenge for this week is to record a memory verse. Film yourself doing the memory verse with as much energy as you can and send it in to us. We would love to see that. See you soon. And don't forget, yes, Jesus died for us. See ya. And because he's alive, we know that the way is open.
so that we can live forever and be friends with God and never die too.
Mm.